They come out of nowhere, silent but deadly. That's right, I'm talking about ninjas. Ninjas have been feared and revered for centuries, and if you want to be one, we're going to show you how. This is Epic How to Be a Ninja. Ninja Vanish!
Epic How To.
Before you start karate chopping people's heads off, let's explain what a ninja is. Originating in 15th century feudal Japan, a ninja or shinobi roughly translates as one who endures. A ninja was an elite spy, assassin, and reconnaissance expert that worked as a mercenary for hire. Basically, these were ancient Navy SEALs. Ninjas were so good at their job, people believed that they had mystical powers, like invisibility or the ability to walk on water. After the Shimabara Rebellion in 1637, ninjas disappeared from recorded history, but they experienced a resurgence in popularity beginning in the 1960s, thanks to an appearance in the James Bond film, You Only Live Twice. A ninja is nothing if he doesn't know martial arts, but where can you learn the style of martial arts that ninjas actually used? The lineage of the ninja is complicated and often disputed by scholars, but most agree that modern ninjutsu began in 1978 with the Bujinkan organization. From there, it splintered off into Genbukan, Jinenkan, Bankei Shinobiden, and Toshindo. Ninja training is designed to make your body like a suit of armor. In feudal Japan, ninjas would have their toes, ankles, heads, and hands beaten with large objects in order to strengthen them. Now, you might think that a ninja walks around looking like this, but actually, ninjas usually wore regular clothes. Think about it. The best disguise is the one that best blends in with your environment. So don't walk around in an all-black getup like some mopey little goth kid. Unless you're surrounded by a bunch of mopey little goth kids, then that's what you should wear. The more normal you appear, the more you're dressing like a ninja. For night missions, where it's essential to remain unseen, ninjas don the shinobi fuku, a tight shirt and knee-length trousers. Notice how the sleeves and the pant legs are tight to prevent them from rustling around and making extra noise. Even though it's night, don't dress in black. Since the night sky is more blue than black, wearing black would actually make you more visible than if you wore navy blue. You'll also want a pair of tabi boots. Tabi boots are made with rubber soles and a split-toe design that allow you to be more silent than other footwear. A ninja is a master of stealth, so it's important that you master the art of walking silently. Always step with the front of your foot first, lifting it no more than 2 to 4 centimeters off of the ground. Put all your weight on the balls of your foot, then repeat the process with the other foot, finally letting your front foot's heel touch the ground. Did you get it? You want to keep a low center of gravity for maximum maneuverability, so don't stop walking with one foot in the air. It needs to be a smooth, fluid motion, so practice this at home until it becomes second nature. To sneak past someone, you want to match the cadence of their steps. This will help mask the natural noise your steps make. Breathe through your mouth rather than your nose as it makes less noise. Ninjas were experts at breaking into places they weren't supposed to be. Ninjas would commonly use grappling hooks and collapsible ladders for getting over tall structures and hammers and chisels for breaking through weak points and walls. But today, a ninja's best bet is probably parkour, because it's awesome. Developed in France in the 80s, parkour is a training discipline to help practitioners navigate complex urban environments in the fastest way possible. Even though ninjas should never be seen, sometimes you need to fight an opponent. While your martial arts instructor will show you a variety of moves, here's an easy takedown to get you started. Put your right arm under your opponent's right armpit. Quickly fall to your left knee and put your right leg around their right ankle. Then shoot forward with your hips, taking the opponent down. Did that sound complicated? Did you not get it? Rewind the video, watch it again. Even the best ninja needs to make a quick exit when they're outnumbered. According to Jinichi Kawakami, director of the Iga-Ryu Ninja Museum in Japan, the first step is to cause a distraction. In the 16th century, ninjas used to use smoke bombs, blinding powder, even boiling hot water to escape sticky situations. But today's ninja needs something that won't get you thrown in jail for assault. Jinichi Kawakami says that even throwing something as small and innocuous as a toothpick can cause someone to look the other way, giving you the chance to escape. Being a ninja is more than just being strong of body, it's about being strong of mind. In his ninja training, Jinichi Kawakami would spend hours staring at a candle to improve his concentration and sharpen his senses. The belief system of a ninja is called Shugendo, roughly translating as the path of training. Shugendo teaches that spiritual enlightenment only comes through surviving physical trials. Practitioners of Shugendo, called Yamabushi, lived in the mountains in isolation and believed this reclusive lifestyle would help them master the elements of water, earth, air, and fire. Common ninja trials involved these four elements, such as standing under waterfalls, meditating on the edge of a cliff, being buried alive, or walking on hot coals. Ninjas also had a strict diet, as being thin helped them move quickly and slip between small spaces. Ninjas had to pack light, so their food was portable and emphasized nutrition over taste. These were the three main ninja recipes. One was Huroyugan, a dumpling made of rice, lotus, yams, and ginseng. Delicious! Another was Kikatsugan, a dumpling made of carrot, flour, rice, yam, and buckwheat. Also delicious. Finally, there was Suikatsugan, which had licorice, mint, and plums. That's like a dessert delicious. Ninjas also believed these foods had mystic properties that would stave off thirst and hunger. Congratulations, my students. I've passed down all of my knowledge and you are now officially ninjas. There's no obstacle you can't climb, no person you can't sneak past, and you can listen to Vanilla Ice's ninja rap without feeling like a total tool. Okay, maybe not that last one, but whatever. I'm Joe Beretta, and this has been Epic How To. Ninja Vanish! Still here. Let us know what topic you guys think we should break down next in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe.